Leonardo da Vinci thought a lot about friction. In his studies, he determined that blocks of the same material and mass experience the same frictional force, regardless of the shape or orientation of the blocks. The size of the apparent area of contact doesn't affect the friction, which seems counter to what we experience. To understand why, we need to zoom in on the surface texture. At this level, the block is not resting on all of the points of the surface, only a small amount of peak material. When the block is set on a hard surface, the highest peak makes contact and tries to resist the load. Most likely, the load is too great, and the peak crushes or plastically deforms. More peaks resist the load and crush, further and further until the load is supported. The area of material that supports the load is called the real area of contact. It's typically a very small percentage of the apparent area of contact. For this 12-inch steel cube, the real area of contact is only about 0.01 inches squared. The amount of friction depends on the real area of contact, and for this case, where the surface deforms plastically, the real area of contact only depends on the material hardness and the force pushing down. The apparent area of contact does not affect the friction at all. However the block is oriented, the amount of peak material making contact remains the same, though it may be distributed differently. Da Vinci observed this fact about friction, but it took modern measurement techniques and microscopes to explain what's really happening. Michigan Metrology provides 3D surface texture measurement and analysis to help solve issues related to friction and surface roughness. Find out how we can help with your surface-related measurements.